everybody, I hope y'all are having a fantabulous day. I know I am. I just ate a bowl of Honey Bunches, honey roasted cereal, and I'm feeling fan-flapping-tastic today. Welcome to another part. Okay, no. That was way too cheery, way too optimistic. Let's run that back. What's going on, everybody? It's your boy here, Chris Stroyer, and you see, now that's more like it, a nice little neutral monotone voice. That's more like it. And welcome back to a little multi-episode series called Sketches from My Art Class. I can't edit in an auditory echo, so, you know, I had to mimic it myself. Anyways, yeah, welcome back to part two, guys. I haven't uploaded in a while because I haven't really gotten a chance to do anything, like even record this, edit it, upload it. I've just had a really busy schedule. You know how it is with like school and everything. It's really stressful. I've been doing a lot since the last time I made a video. You know what I mean? I've been drawing stuff on my newly bought whiteboard over there. Wait, you can't. Hold on. Let me just cut to it. Yeah, this whiteboard right here. I got it a while ago, actually, like a pretty long time ago. You know, and ever since then, I've been drawing stuff on it. Like, as you can see, here's a little goldfish. You know, I guess this is a nice segue into the beginning of the video. You know, this is the first sketch that I'll be showing you guys. I actually drew this today for a little do now assignment in art class. We had to do a 5-minute sketch where we drew a goldfish inside of a fish bowl. I mean, this one looks kind of simplistic, but I feel like, you know, hey, it was a 5-minute drawing. You know what I mean? He didn't ask for a whole Leonardo da Vinci masterpiece. You know what I mean? So, yeah. Okay, so I pretty much have these sketches like assorted in a random order. I think I'll be showing you guys like about 5 to 6, then I'll stop the video. Wait, hold up. Let me back up. You know, can't have toes in a non-toe related video. I'll stop. Let's just get into the drawings already, okay? So first off, and my apologies if I accidentally show you guys the next drawing without intending to show it. Let me back up a little bit. All right, good. All right, so first off, we got a mouse. I actually drew this a while ago. We were supposed to draw like a random animal. I think I did pretty good. I mean, I could have done a little bit better with the placing of the arms, you know, and the ears. I mean, the ears look kind of all right, you know. I mean, the little highlight, the little tail, it looks pretty cute in my opinion. You know, pretty basic, pretty cool, nice shading. You know, overall, I think it's a nice sketch. I'd give it a solid 8 out of 10, I guess. No, that's too generous. Like 6.9. Yeah, 6.9. Okay, let's just call it 7.2. Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty good. Anyway, next drawing. Okay, so right here we got what seems to be a paintbrush. I mean, that's obviously what it is. It's what I intended it to be. Once again, it was obviously for art class. We had to do, I don't remember what we had to do for these. Like, I think we had to draw like any random object that could be found inside of a an art class, I think. Yeah. I just, you know, the first thing that came to mind was obviously a paintbrush, you know what I mean? But I decided to draw a wide paintbrush because, you know, I'm trying to be original. Anyway, yeah, it's pretty cool. Got some little red paint on here. The only problem with this that I had is, like, you know, I couldn't find a way to make it, like, look less square. It just looks a bit square up here, you know what I mean? I tried to add that little shine to it to represent the paint, you know what I mean? I mean, at least I did pretty good with the shading. It looks, like, pretty 3D, you know what I mean? At least I did good on that. I could have done better, but I did pretty well, you know? Give it a solid 7 out of 10. Okay, 6 out of 10. You know, gotta humble myself. Anyway, next drawing. But before that, let me just show you something that's a bit, you know, old, a little bit of an old original idea of mine. We had to do something related to texture once again. We had to draw several different objects with several different textures. I decided to do mouses, you know, computer mouses. I mean, look, I know, it's horrible. I get it. But, you know, I tried my best. This is supposed to be a wet mouse, a bumpy mouse, and a regular mouse. So, yeah, that's that. Anyway, let's just get to the main stuff, the main stuff. Okay, so this, obviously, like, this has got to be one of my best drawings yet. Not even, no cap. Like, it's, you know what I mean? My friends were impressed, and like all of them, like every single person that I showed this drawing to said, hey, that looks like the one penguin from that one movie. I just looked up a picture of a random penguin online and drew it from reference. You know what I mean? I wasn't meaning to reference Happy Feet in any way, you know? But whatever, you know, it doesn't matter. At least they think it's good. You know what I mean? Whatever perspective they view it from, I'm all right with that. So, yeah. You know, there's my name right there. I don't think you can see it that well. I mean, it doesn't even matter, you know. It's like, you guys are going to find out my first name and my last name eventually. Why not just rip the bandage off right now? So anyway, yeah, definitely a solid 10 out of 10. And, you know, I mean, I feel like I really did well on the feet, the coloring. You know what I mean? If you search up a picture of a penguin online, you'll definitely see the resemblance. Yeah, 10 out of 10. Perfect. Like, really feel like I did really good on this. Anyway, next drawing. These next two drawings, I drew during the time that my class had to work with something called op art. It's basically art that involves you drawing optical illusions, you know what I mean? Most people know that already, so I didn't really have to point it out like that. But anyway, yeah, I feel like I did amazing with these, you know what I mean? You can definitely see the optical illusional appeal that they have. This next one, obviously, I'm not going to describe it to you. I mean, you can pretty much already tell what it is, but, like, you know, you'll definitely, you'll be able to truly identify it in its entirety once I turn it around. Let me just look it. Let me stop rambling and turn it around already. Boom, there we go. There we go. That's it. It's a heart. And it has those little black lines on it. You know, we had to draw an object in the middle of the paper that and make it look 3D by making it interact with the background design. You know what I mean? I feel like I did pretty good, but it could have been a little bit better. I feel like maybe I should have done vertical lines on it as well. You know, but overall, I think it looks pretty nice. You know, solid 7 out of 10, my opinion. Okay, next and final drawing. Okay, out of all the previous drawings that I just accidentally bit my tongue, out of all the drawings that I've just showed you guys, I feel like this one truly takes the cake. You can already pretty much see what it is, but, you know, you'll see what it is once I turn it around. But before that, let me just show you this one on the back. Like, I think I reused this same paper because I was running out of paper in my sketchbook. But anyway, let's not focus on that. So yeah, Faygo, Cola, you know, shout out to my Michiganders. Anyway, let's get into the final drawing. And there we go. We basically, what did we have to do for this? Oh yeah, we had to draw lines all over the paper and then do different curves in each of those lines going from, like, you know, smaller inward to bigger outward, you know, to make it have this, like, kind of tunnel effect that you can see in different ways, you know what I mean? Yeah, it looks pretty good in my opinion. Let me give it a spin. Bow, bow. Yeah, pretty cool. It's pretty cool. And yeah, that was the final drawing that I had to show you guys. I still have many more, and I'm going to continue making more, you know what I mean, until I find something else to put on this channel. But till then, you know what I mean, thanks for watching this, guys. If you stay till the end, thank you so much for watching it. You know, like, every little view helps, you know what I mean? Really excited to see what kind of future content I'm going to put on this channel. You know, I can't wait for the day that I look back at this and say, wow, is that really where I was at? I can't believe that I was there then compared to where I am now. You know what I mean? Can't wait for when that day comes. Anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching. Be sure to leave a like and subscribe. Maybe leave a comment. You know, tell me what else I should possibly put on this channel. You know what I mean? And until then, I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace.